Hey everybody, this is Jeff Posnick coming to you from New York City, and welcome to this week's episode of YouTube Developers Live. This week we're going to be talking about how to debug issues that you might be having when trying to craft your YouTube Analytics API reports. This is something that we've seen a number of developers have a little bit of confusion about, and you know, while following the documentation should get you where you need to go, we wanted to provide a little bit of extra hints and tips for folks who might be running into issues. So let's dive in right now by pulling up a copy of my screen, and I'll show you what we're talking about. So right now we have the YouTube Analytics API Explorer open right now, and this is a great way of being able to run sample queries. I highly recommend that folks try this out, and we'll have a little annotation pointing to it before you actually write any code that uses the Analytics API, because you could try out all the different parameter combinations. It'll take you through the OAuth2 flow, and it'll allow you to just see which parameters work and which don't work in a real-time fashion. So we're going to be using this for all our debugging today. And another really useful resource that I'm going to pull open right here is something from our documentation, which is a list of all the supported parameters for the different types of reports. And it's kind of like, I don't want to say it's a matrix or anything like that, but it kind of does give you a list of the different dimensions that are supported, and given those dimensions, these are the metrics that are supported, a real nice breakdown there. So we're going to walk through how to interpret those pieces of information that are in the docs. And finally, there's this other page which has some kind of predefined requests that are known to work. So these are the exact combinations of parameters that you could use for specific common queries, and kind of think of this as a cookbook that you could use with guaranteed things that work for doing things like getting country-specific view counts or daily watch time metrics for channels, videos, things like that. So let's jump back though, and we're going to go into the API Explorer. The first source of confusion that we see for a lot of folks is that they don't really know how to populate the value over here for the IDs parameter. If you're running a channel level report, which most folks will be doing, you kind of do need to know a piece of information that most people don't know off the top of their head, and that's your YouTube channel ID. There are a couple different ways of getting that channel ID, and the easiest way, and the way that I'm going to go through right now, is just visiting a special page on youtube.com, which is youtube.com/account_advanced. And this page gives you some advanced information about your channel, including your YouTube channel ID. There are definitely ways of looking this up via the API to get the channel ID of the currently authenticated user. You could do a youtube.channels.list API call with the mine equals true parameter set. We have lots of code samples in our documentation showing that, but this is just a really easy way using the docs to pull it up right here. So I'm logged into a test account right now. I'm going to copy that. And I'm going to put in channel equals equals and that value. And just there's an extra space right there I want to get rid of. So that part's good. The start date and end date, two required parameters. That one, fortunately, a little bit harder to mess up. You just need to do the format of, you know, 4-digit year, 2-digit month, 2-digit day. And we're going to do a report that spans the entire year of 2012. And now we're getting into things that, you know, vary from report to report. I'm going to show you how you do a very simple report, which is to get the total number of views aggregated by video for that given year. So I'm going to refer back to this this matrix right here. And the dimension that I'm interested in is video. So I'm looking up in this list of supported values, and dimension video, I could get these different metrics. So I want views in that particular case, and that's great. And let's just start with that. Let's say I kind of naively think, okay, metrics views and dimensions video. Okay, I'm done, right? I'm just gonna go down here, click execute, and I get back the dreaded 400 bad request. So that's actually not a report that will work. And if I go over here, you know, this kind of pulls up that same page that I was on. We do give you a handy URL that you could visit. So what went wrong? The problem is actually that you need to have a sort restriction and a max results restriction. So these two columns over here are actually quite important. It's not just like optional values that you need to use. You actually do need to put in either one. You need to put in one of these sort restrictions, and you need to request 10 or fewer videos in the results. And this is just due to some backend limitations on the YouTube Analytics API infrastructure. So we do kind of spelled out over here, but this is something that a lot of people have trouble with. So we're going to put in sort by decreasing views. This minus right in front of the views is really important. It means that we're sorting by decreasing views, and we need to put 10 or fewer for the max results. So let's go back up here. We have max results. I'm going to put in 10 and sort by decreasing views. Click execute again. And lo and behold, get back some metrics from my very unpopular test channel. So that shows you that you really do need to be careful about what the required parameters are over here. And if you're not sure, going to this cookbook page and seeing all these combination parameters that are guaranteed to work for specific types of reports is a really useful thing to do. So that's actually all I wanted to cover today. Thanks so much for joining us, and hopefully this will help you get started with the YouTube Analytics API. Bye, everybody.